Here we go, lads. I just realized I'm still in the group. Ah, it'll be fine. What? Oh, yeah, I gotta leave the group. Sorry, guys.
There have been several skirmishes along the border, but as yet neither side has delivered a decisive blow. We had long assumed that the Garleans would overwhelm us in a straight fight, but we seem to be gaining ground, albeit slowly. As to why that might be, the most likely explanation is that they have yet to commit all their forces. Still, we are winning, and our latest intelligence suggests the Emperor has retreated back to Garlemald. In light of this, we're considering launching an offensive with the aim of pushing the front line forward and giving ourselves some room to breathe.
I feel like that's gonna backfire.
Commander! The Imperials! They've broken through our defenses to the east!
Oh shit.
What?
Our scouts say their forces are being led by Lord Zenos. Lord Heian and Commander Hext have taken their troops to provide support. But we don't know how long they can hold out.
So, they've been biding their time, waiting for his arrival, have they? Very well. Send word to our allies, requesting reinforcements for the front line.
Let's see if this Ascian can play a good Zenos.
Should the worst come to the worst, I may need to enter the fray myself. But what of you? Do you still have the strength to fight?
Hell yeah, General.
Plus an additional 10 each for reprint sage.
You need only say the word, so long as you leave the Ascian to me. I kinda wanna say the second one, cause it sounds more badass, but at the same time... No, so long as you leave the Ascian to me. But, thing is, I don't really have a way to kill the Ascian right now.
He may not die as such, but to see Lord Zenos fall on the battlefield would deal a heavy blow to Imperial morale.
Hell yeah.
I'll see to it the men stay clear.
Oh shit.
Why won't they open? Please, I bid you open.
Oh, the gates of our mind. That must be what it's referring to. That's why he's trying to grab our souls.
What's wrong?
Fuck you, Zodiark. Yeah. And I'm the last one standing, other than Kryl.
Sure, fit state to do this.
Well, and the other Scions who are not the Power Ranger team Scions.
May Ralgar grant us strength.
That's one way to say it.
Give 'em hell, lad. I, for my part, will defend this place to my dying breath.
Same. Not the most epic way to say it, but same. We'll hold our ground, or die trying. Meanwhile, the border of Alamigo. I'm still standing, but I don't know if that's the same song, but that's the song that came to mind. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. Great, now that's playing in the back of my head when this music is going on. Ah, shit. Am I gonna take Hien's control of Hien? Yeah, of course I am. Of course! Healing circle. Should've, I'm dumb for not.
Oh, please, no one die. Oh, fuck me. Oh, tense.
Sounds like the World War II out there. My heart is actually beating very harsh right now. Oh, fuck.
Magic. With a Garlean body. That's hardly fair.
Yeah.
Still, he must be stopped. No matter the cost.
Stay down. Good. You better keep your ass down right now and get out of here. I'll fucking deal with it.
Bringer of light. It has been too long.
Go fuck yourself. Elidibus.
No words to mark our reunion? So be it. Equilibrium must be restored. And only your death will redress the balance.
Bring it. Let's see whose death brings what about. He's a good mock Xenos, that's for sure.
Thank you.
Crap! Damn it. Oh, do I start? Come on. Go the fuck down! Go down.
I see.
Fuck walls. Oh, God damn it. Whoever said I needed to do that is Sam. Never mind. Fuck, I'm tense. Oh man. I'm all sore over.
Your mother chose her champion well. Yet, for all your strength, you will.
Thank you, this was a door for the super chat, man. Thank you. Much
more
appreciated.
Gil for the cause.
Please, I beseech you.
Zodiark, fuck yourself.
Someone calls to you. Too late, alas.
He doesn't know it's Zodiark? Or is it not Zodiark? This was my assumption. Cancer fun. It's not Heidelin.
At last, I found you.
Who the fuck are you?
Please, there's no cause for alarm.
Excuse? Who? Oh, please, there's no cause for alarm. Says you.
Though, I confess, this is not where I had intended to meet.
Where did you intend to meet?
But the place of our meeting is of no consequence. Like the war you wage. Win or lose, the path you walk leads only to oblivion. The better path leads you here, to me. I have need of your strength.
So does everybody else. Why should I prioritize yours? I don't know who the fuck you are. You have to send me back now. I'm kind of torn between both. Shroud the character would be more concerned about his friends. You send me back now.
The battle is over, the danger past, but your work is not yet done. Go to the Crystal Tower. I have left something for you near its base. It will serve as a beacon of sorts, one which I pray will help you on your journey. All you need do is find it. I will take care of the rest.
Wait a minute, this isn't... Ah, fuck, what was his name? It's been so long. The cat boy, with the one with the red eye and the other colored eye. It's not him, is it? We know he's been locked in the tower for so long. Can't remember his name. Fuck. That's a rhetorical question, don't answer it. We'll find out, I suppose.
Soon, we will throw wide the gates.
To what?
And the path to the first will be yours to walk at last.
Gahatia? Took you over 5 attempts? I barely did it in 2. Barely. Whoa! Honoroi? Or Onowa? I always say Honoroi, but it's Onowa.
We're in Ishgard?
You're awake. Thank heavens.
I don't know. Are you ready? I don't know if I'm ready. I'm so lost. Yeah, where's Xenos?
I see you recall that much, at least. In the midst of your duel, it is said you faltered, and that the Crown Prince seized the opportunity to deliver a mortal blow. Yet before his blade could find its mark, he was distracted by the arrival of a second adversary who bore you away from the battlefield and into the hands of our Chirurgeons.
Huh?
Lest you wonder, he left before you awoke. As is his wont.
Astinian, of course.
Astinian never was one for emotional farewells.
No kidding. But definitely one for timely arrivals. Jesus Christ. I don't feel good about having to be saved, though.
Though Xenos bested all before him, the battle clearly took its toll, for he retreated shortly after your rescue. Seeing this, the remaining Imperial forces decided discretion was the better part of valor and pulled back, allowing us to re-establish our position. We have since received word of renewed unrest in the provinces, doubtless inspired by the efforts of the Eorzean Alliance and our Far Eastern allies.
Tanked for you? Yeah, and he's a Dragoon, they're DPS.
Nor does the good news end there. We have also come into possession of intelligence suggesting unrest within the Imperial Court. This would certainly explain why both the Emperor and Lord Xenos appear to have abandoned the fight. A long-awaited ray of hope in these dark times.
No kidding. Bamf is kind of a Bamf. Bamf? Is they alright? What are the Scions? And kind of both the same question.
Yet to awake, I'm afraid. But please, concentrate on your own recovery for now. You have carried the hopes of some half-dozen nations, and we are all eternally grateful for your efforts. But no one is without their limits, not even you. Leave this fight to us, my friend. You have earned your rest. Ah, but before I forget, I was asked to deliver a message as soon as you awoke.
What's the message?
A reminder that you are not alone, though many of your allies have fallen. When you are well and rested, you are to return home, where friends will be waiting for you. Now, if you will excuse me, I must return to the front. May we meet again soon, under happier circumstances.
Aye. thing feels so heavy. Fuck. Tataru! She's back! Well, at least she's alright. I'm alive! I ain't dead!
By the 12! I don't believe it!
You don't believe I'm alive? I'd hope you believe I'm alive. Goddamn. Oh, I kinda wanna just reach down and hug her. It's okay. I ain't dead. Pat on the head.
As soon as I could. I swear, my heart nearly stopped when I heard you'd collapse like the others. What in heaven's name is going on?
Where to begin?
Win or lose, the path you walk leads only to oblivion. Oh, well, that's helpful. And what else did he say? The better path leads to him?
Sounds kind of biased and presumptuous, you sound me, if you ask me, but...
If his is the voice you've all been hearing, perhaps the others are with him!
Optimistically.
Sir Emmerich said the fighting had reached a stalemate, didn't he? But if that monster masquerading as Xenos comes back... Thancred, Yestola, Urianche, Alphano, Alize... You're going to need all of them on your side to defeat him!
Yes, we will.
And I forbid you from going to face him on your own, do you hear me?
I don't know if I can keep that.
So if you must leave... Go and find the others. Bring them home.
That's the goal.
As for where to start, you said the stranger had left a beacon for you at the Crystal Tower, right?
Supposedly.
But how are you to find it, now that the tower has been sealed shut? There has to be a way. If anyone would know, it's Cid, and the researchers of St. Coinax's find. Don't you worry, we'll find that beacon for you.
True hero. Meanwhile, the Temple of Doom. I hope they're reeling from the loss. Noah.
I pray you have good reason for abandoning the front.
How could I remain there while the rumor that my son is possessed by a demon spreads like a sickness here at home? I will not be made to fight for the throne a second time. But what of you? Did you not tell me you would destroy Eorzea's champion with the ease that one might swat a fly?
A minor setback. He will not escape me again. Where is your grandsire? I would have word with him.
How should I know? Do you hide from each other's sight as well? I imagine he's doing what all Asians do.
He must have found a way to take advantage of this turmoil.
Men are not pawns to be played with, Ascian. You underestimate us at your peril. This war will not be decided by you and yours. Man must choose his own fate, and I, for my part, will do all within my power to see Garlemald emerge victorious.
Family relationships. Well, the thing is, it's not family relationships, because Xenos is more or less what's happening is Anassian is wearing his son's corpse as a suit.
But the requested preparations are now complete.
So, the only part of it that's family is him and Solas.
We stand ready to begin production of Black Rose upon your order.
Ah, fuck. Fucking A, guys. Oh. I need a second. Listen to the music of this. Oh, man. Congrats. Thanks, guys. In one stream, we went from the start of 4.3 to the end of 4.56. Almost at 12 hours. We're at 11 hours, 28 minutes, and 20 seconds. I don't want to skip the credits. We'll let them play a little bit. Rate point for Stormblood? I already gave you guys my rating for Stormblood. I've already explained that I don't see the post Stormblood expansions or I don't see any post expansion patches in FF specifically as part of the core patch, even if they are technically. The reason is how the story unfolds. The entirety of the core expansion of 4.0 is, in my opinion, one completely rounded story, right? Everything feels wrapped up in its own conclusive way, and the patches are kind of like a second book. Like they feel like a short story in between the core expansions, which are like the mainline books. So I see the post patches as their own story. But I see them kind of not as a prologue, not even as part of the actual book, but more like a short story sequel to the core book. That's the way to see it, like, novelization-wise. That's just how it feels in FF to me. So I don't consider everything we've done today, or the last couple days, with you guys will even notice in the titles for the streams, I don't put FFXIV Stormblood, I put FFXIV The Legend Returns. And even the devs name the patches their own thing. Like, for example, for Heavensward, the post-Heavensward, post 3.0 patches were all called the Dragonsong War Arc. And the post-Stormblood patches were all The Legend Returns. And I'm sure the post patches for Shadowbringers are going to have their own name too, and even going to feel like a next follow-up story. So I would say for the Legend Returns arc, or otherwise known as the post 4.0 patches, damn good story. Damn good follow-up to Stormblood, and what a hell of a setup for Shadowbringers. I don't know what Shadowbringers is going to look like, but goddamn, we're going to find out. Not tomorrow, because tomorrow's another full day of working on Warglaive, so you guys won't see me tomorrow. Before I go to bed tonight, it's 12:31 in the morning where I'm at, but I gotta get at least one video prepared for tomorrow in my absence, and then hopefully get other videos prepped. And the best part is I don't have to record anything, because I'm probably gonna be fresh at the moment I actually stop, like, talking and stop the stream and everything. All my energy is gonna seep out of me. Ah, man. Alright. Yeah, I'm not gonna play the whole credits. I wanted to play that beginning part, so. Remember to leave a like and subscribe.